Quilters Newsletter TV, the Quilters community, is brought to you by Handy Quilter, designed by a quilter for quilters, and Husqvarna Viking, keeping the world sewing for over 140 years. Hi, and welcome to Quilters Newsletter TV, the Quilters community. I'm Mary Kate Karr-Petras, and I'm here with Karen Charles. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
Karen is an event specialist with Husqvarna Viking, and today she is going to show us some techniques for using decorative stitches for crazy quilting, correct?
Absolutely.
And tell us a little bit about some of the stitches that you used here.
Well, most of these are simple stitches that are on the machine. Some of them are specifically vintage stitches that have a very heavy look to them. And ones that aren't, I'm going to show you some simple ways of making them have a really bold and beautiful look to them.
And this is a great opportunity for what I like to call extra retail therapy. We don't, as quilters, don't always get to use these beautiful sparkly threads, but this is a great opportunity to use some of these.
Yeah, right? Absolutely. I use a lot of metallics. And in our bobbin work, we're going to use a lot of heavier cords that you couldn't put through the needle. Mm-hmm. So it gives us an opportunity to really do something like this one over here. That thread was stitched upside down, and we were stitching with a bobbin case.
Okay.
So you're going to see that a little bit later.
Okay.
But to start with, I just thought I'd talk about setting up our machine.
Okay.
Where I mostly work with rayons and metallics. We're working on a Sapphire 960Q today, which I love because it's got an amazing array of decorative stitches. And I'll open the lid here so you can get a sense mm-hmm. of what they're like. Some of them are vintage. Some of them... most of them are 7 millimeters wide, but then we have a whole selection of them that are 25 millimeters wide, much wider than the opening in your foot control. Mm-hmm. So the material is actually sewing side to side to do those really elaborate wide stitches. So we're going to start by changing our foot, and all of those Husqvarna Viking feet just pull off like that. And we're going to be putting on a foot that's got a flange to it. It's called a decorative edge joining foot.
Okay.
And we're going to use it to help us guide down the seam so that we get a really nice straight stitch. I'm going to slip it on, and I've got a decorative stitch selected on my screen. This is the one we're going to use. Now, one thing I love about the decorative stitches on Husqvarna Viking machines is we can adjust the density. It used to be that if we wanted to make a stitch denser, we'd have to shorten it up and then we'd lose the quality of the stitch. Now we can go in, touch the Alt button, and we can change it. But for today, we're going to do something even more extremely exciting.
Okay.
And we're going to work with two threads at one time through the needle. Now, they make different needles for different reasons. This would be a good reason to put a top stitch needle on. And I have at home a 8-spool thread rack that attaches to the back. And I like to use that because the threads come up and over into the machine, and they both have the same tension on them. When you have one thread that's vertical and one thread that's horizontal, they both have a different amount of tension on them. So that's something to consider if you like to do a lot of this kind of work.
Okay.
Definitely worth it to get a thread rack where all of it's coming out. We're gonna be working on that stitch, and we're gonna set it up right here on that seam. I'm putting the foot down. As usual, I wanna set my machine so that the needle stops in the down position. And if you have that feature on your machine and you're not using it, it should be part of your everyday sewing life, is to set your machine like that. Because
okay.
when you're working with decorative stitches, if you stop at any point, it will remember exactly where you are, and then the decorative stitch will look consistent and even when you're doing it. So when I start up, you can see how that flange is sitting right against the
right.
edge of that.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that amazing? So I don't really even have to touch the fabric. It's just feeding right in there. I'll go a little farther just to give you an idea.
Now I notice you're stitching on a foundation, even though this
I
is
am.
Not a foundation piece block.
That's a good point. I've put a piece of tearaway underneath there because that's going to keep my fabric nice and flat, and the decorative stitches are not going to get, you know, crinkled in or pulled in at all.
And this is not a quilting stitch.
This is a
decorative stitch.
And we have on this machine, we have vintage stitches. This is I'm anxious to see what it looks like. I can't see it from my angle.
It's beautiful.
And so I'm going to come to the end of where that seam intersects, and I can use the scissors to cut the top and bottom thread. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to notice a couple of things. I used not very traditional quilting fabrics. These are not cotton fabrics. Mm-hmm. These are dress, you know, very silky fabrics, but they sit very nice. And when you stitch on them, you're still getting that really beautiful look to them. Mm-hmm. Crazy quilting is kind of nice because a lot of the work you do with the foundation, if it was something very slinky, you could even back it with a very thin no-show mesh or something that would add a little bit of body to it. But these are just straight, you know, out of the dress aisle of fabric. But because they're meant for that, there's a lot of coordinating fabrics and a lot of really strong decorative colors to it. You'll notice that when I put this together, this was the first seam that I sewed together, and then I added this fabric and this fabric, mm-hmm. and then these two on the outside mm-hmm. edge. So where I'm going to start is always going to be the first fabric seam that I put together. That's where I'm going to start the stitch.
In the same order you
pieced. I'm going to start at the beginning and finish here, mm-hmm. so that when I do the next decorative seam over it, I'm going to cover up that beginning and end point.
Okay.
And so I'll get that nice continuous look to my stitching.
Fantastic. Well, you have a couple of other techniques that you can
Absolutely.
Show us today. All right, let's take a look at this one.
So this is a really pretty unique one. This is called a three-hole yarn foot, and I've put the yarn into it already. Let me see if I can get that out for you a little better. And I've tied a knot in the back so that they don't slide out while I'm trying to show you this.
Ah.
And the yarns just go through holes in the foot. And to start it up, I'm going to change my foot. And sometimes the best techniques are just a simple matter of using the right foot for the right job.
Yeah.
And where I have that knot, I'm going to make sure it goes into the back like that.
Okay.
I can leave both threads on, and I'll do that. I'll choose a different stitch, though, so you'll be able to see it better. See the yarns and what I'm doing. So I'm going to go to the stitch menu, and I'm going to choose a stitch from the D menu. And I think I'm going to choose, maybe I'm going to choose this one. It's a big open stitch. Mm-hmm. It probably will work well. And you'll be able to see the yarn through it. So I'm going to choose another seam, right here. And that's the one I'm going to do. And then you'll be able to see how that develops. Now, when I look at this stitch, the width of it, if I wanted to check it, the width is 7 millimeters. You won't get as good a result with stitches that are wider. 7 millimeters means that the machine is going to sew straight forward, and it's not going to move the fabric side to side. If I get into a very wide stitch and the fabric's moving side to side, it's not going to be as appealing a look.
Okay.
Okay. So I make sure that the knot that I have in the back is back there, and I'm going to put my foot down. Again, my needle set in the down position. And these things are all twisted around. I don't have to worry about them. I don't even have to touch them, because even if they get twisted, by the time they go through the foot, they straighten themselves out. And so I'm going to start up. And you can see how uncaring I am. They're just laid there. I don't have to push or pull them. And if I had a really crooked seam allowance underneath it, this is a good way of camouflaging it.
Okay.
Go. So this one I'm going to lift the foot up, and you can see how dramatic that looks.
It really
There's
is.
A lot of extra body to that stitch, and then I can come in and just cut them off. And every time you change the yarn or change the stitch or the thread, it's going to give you a completely different look.
Yes,
to it.
Indeed. That's really
Isn't
dramatic.
That fun?
Mm-hmm.
So this was a couple of pieces of yarn and then some finer things that were all put through those holes. I'm going to take them out now so that you can see the holes and what they look like.
I see. Okay, great.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah, that's great.
Such a simple way of getting some added dimension mm-hmm. to it.
For our last technique?
The last technique is really exciting.
That's what I'm looking forward to.
We're going to be doing some bobbin work.
Okay.
And I'm putting in this cord that's a little heavier, and it's going to give us a raised look. I've done a stitch like this here. I've got purple thread instead of the pink, but mm-hmm. it'll give you an idea of what it's going to look like. And instead of clicking it into the tension when I put it in here, I'm just going to drop it in and bring it up. I'm not going to put it into the tension at all.
Oh, okay.
I have a specialty bobbin case that's in there that I've been working with The main difference between a regular bobbin case and the specialty bobbin case is the back of it is cut out. And I'm not sure if you can see this all that well with the black, but the specialty bobbin case has got a big groove cut out that allows the decorative stitches to go through. And so it is a really easy to do it successfully and be happy with the way it looks.
Okay.
So we're going to put our regular clear B foot back on. And this time I'm going to touch the needle up down and pull it up. And then it's going to pull my cord up for me like that. Okay.
Sort of like for regular machine
quilting. Right, an older machine,
yeah.
You would have to bring up your bobbin thread. Well, on the Husqvarna Vikings, you don't have to bring up your bobbin thread. When, if you cut, it stays down below, and you start sewing again, it doesn't need to be up near the top.
Got it.
But this technique needs to be up near the top so that you can make sure it's feeding well and going well. And the other main difference between this is instead of us sewing on the top of our fabric, we're going to be sewing upside down because that's where our decorative thread is. I'll usually match my upper thread to the color of the cord that I'm working with because it gives me a really, I should be using a wider foot too because I think we're going to use a big decorative stitch for this one here. We're going to go into the G menu and we're going to do that stitch. If I look, this stitch is 30 millimeters wide. At one point, it's going to be coming very, very wide. And so it's suggesting that I put the S foot on.
I see.
Which is a big wide foot, and it's going to control the material well.
So this is not a free motion thing.
It's not free motion.
It's decorative
stitch. This is a decorative stitch. And it's a gorgeous decorative. Yeah. I mean, it's 30 millimeters wide. It's amazing. It'll start off narrower, and then it'll go. And the only thing I need to do is put my foot on the pedal and start sewing.
Okay.
Doesn't look like much right now, does it?
Mm-hmm.
And then it's going to do another one. If I want it to stop, I can press the stop button and it'll stop at the end of the repeat. So I'm going to do that because I think I'll get another one out of it. Almost done. And it's going to stop on its own, so I don't even need to think about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I won't use the cutter this time because the cord is so heavy, it won't be able to cut properly.
Okay.
So I'm pulling it out, and
wow.
Look at that. Isn't that
yeah.
amazing? Let me put it down here for you all to see it. See how
that's
heavy that is?
Really,
isn't that gorgeous?
It's really
And this is the other example
so
where
looking.
I did that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just got a quality to it that's raised up, and it's in really rich looking, so.
It's beautiful. Well, let's take a look at some of the other samples you brought with you. Different fabric choices yielded some very different results.
Now, crazy quilting's been around for centuries, and the Victorians used to use it in a lot of their clothes. This one has that more of a feel of a Victorian one. Still not using any embroidery. These are all decorative stitches. There's lace that's been attached. There's the stem's been done with a decorative stitch, and then the buttons have been sewn on with the machine. Oh, if I had time, I would have shown you that. That's fun. If you haven't
we'll
sewn
have
buttons
have
on with a machine, that is the best way to do it. I sewed on a quilt block. I sewed 59 buttons on in less than 10 minutes. It was amazing. And this is a Christmas stocking that I made. Still, you can notice the heavier cords that are applied and worked in with a lot of the specialty feet. They give you that kind of really beautiful look. None of these are ribbons. They're all just decorative stitches that are put on in a certain way to kind of give you that very rich look to it.
Well, as you said, a lot of quilters have these decorative stitches on their machines,
absolutely.
And we don't use them because we just need a straight stitch or, you know, maybe a zigzag occasionally. This is a great inspiration to start experimenting, start playing, break out some of these really beautiful sparkly threads.
Time to go for it. And it's really not a big commitment. One block, you do something small. It's a great way to play with your machine, get to know it, and you'd be surprised how exciting it will be.
And crazy quilting is totally traditional. I mean, Absolutely. It has a long, as you said, a long tradition in the quilt world. It goes in and out of vogue, but it's always something that's very accepted, and people love seeing them up close. Yeah. So there's no reason not to give it a try.
No, absolutely.
Thanks again for being here
You're
today.
Welcome.
Thank you for joining us, and be sure to check our website and our YouTube channel for all of the other tutorials that we've had here with Karen. Take care, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Quilters Newsletter TV, the Quilters community, is brought to you by Handy Quilter, designed by a quilter for quilters, and Husqvarna Viking, keeping the world sewing for over 140 years.